The Pap Attack.
2 weeks ago, leadership at Liberty University in Virginia told young Democrats that they weren't entitled to recognition as a sanctioned organization on that campus. You see, at Liberty, only Republicans are welcome. Jerry Falwell was the founder of Liberty, and it's clear that his legacy lives on. At Falwell's funeral, big praise was heaped on Falwell by Republican politicos. Read some of those praise speeches, and you might conclude that Falwell's soul was heading north at the end of that day. But the more you learn about Falwell and his creepy university, the easier it is to believe that his spirit could have just as easily taken a more southerly course. Falwell was a perfect example of the holy-mouthed political operatives that have done so much damage to Christianity. For 8 years, we heard the Falwell bunch ignore the Gospels and the Beatitudes. Instead, we could usually count on the Falwell Liberty University-type scholars to deliver recycled GOP political hate speeches directed at liberals, abortion doctors, stem cell researchers, intellectuals, minorities, and virtually anything that didn't fit neatly into their judgmental, regressive view of all of humanity. Christianity suffered because of that. If those young Democrats who lost their organization status at Liberty followed Falwell's money trail, I'm sure they'd gladly move their club registration and their student registration to a less loathsome institution. Part of that money trail takes us back to a time when Falwell received millions of dollars from Sun Yong-moon in order to keep the doors open at Liberty University. Moon, you might recall, is the barely 5-foot-tall North Korean immigrant felon who launched the Moonie movement worldwide. Moon came to America after he'd been convicted of stealing from Japanese widows who were paying him money to release their husband's soul from hell after their husband's death. It's not clear how many souls Moon helped escape from hell, but one thing is very clear. Moon is part lunatic and part fraud. Falwell knew it and took his money anyway. Falwell also knew that Moon had a very long-time personal relationship with North Korean dictator Kim Jong-il and, in fact, pledged almost $400 million to North Korea's dictatorial regime. And, you know, with all those Liberty scholars walking around the halls of that university that, by the way, still teaches creationism, it seems like somebody would have known about the quotes by Moon where he tells us that he's actually the incarnate Messiah and that the world should remove the crucifixion crosses from their walls because Moon proclaimed that Christian symbol to be satanic. Those kinds of quotes were just fine with Falwell if the Moon money was big enough. It didn't seem to bother the Liberty faculty that this tiny, delusional Korean had been sentenced to 18 months in a U.S. prison for tax fraud and conspiracy to obstruct justice. When you look closely at the history, you're left wondering whether Falwell was a Moonie or whether Moon is a Christian. And you certainly have to wonder why a group of teenage Democrats have been told that their kind are not welcome at Liberty, a campus that was built on the money from people like Sun Yong-moon.
The Pap Attack on Air America Radio Network.